Welcome to FootballGamePlan.com, where football makes sense. I'm Emory Hunt, the czar of the playbook, bring you another edition of Film Session with the Czar. And today, I'm in my home office, and we're going to break down quarterback Seth Lobato out of Northern Colorado to see if his game translates well to the National Football League level and to see why he's one of the most underrated quarterbacks in this year's draft class. One thing that I'm looking for is how well he can do in the red zone, how well can he diagnose coverage, and how well can he get rid of the football on time at the top of his drop. You see right here versus Idaho State, they're in the red zone, and you see quarters coverage right here. I don't know if you guys can see my laser pointer, so I'll just point 1, 2, 3, 4. They're in some sort of quarters coverage, so you know where the void is. Quarters coverage is designed to funnel everything in front of them, keep everything in front of them, and protect the deep. So you know you have certain voids in this defense. Now, by formation, they can send a tight end here and the receiver here and put this guy in the bind. Same things on the backside there in the ace set. One back in the backfield right here. But we're going to let this thing roll a little bit, see how well he does. Now, they're showing quarters, but you don't know if these two outside guys are coming. So it could be a bit of a combo coverage. So we're going to see here at the snap of the ball. Boom, stop it. It's quarters coverage because these guys didn't leave their zones. They're drifting back. And you see right here at the top of his drop. That's the most important thing. Now that decision has to be made. The back foot is planted. Where can he go with the football? This is taken away. This cornerback is in great position. And he's also sitting in a great spot right here as well. Linebacker is carrying this route by the tight end. And also this linebacker, these two backers right here, are combo covering, banjo covering this guy coming underneath. So the only opportunity he has to throw this football is here in this void. Why? Because one, this guy is out of position. I don't know what he's looking at. His job is to stay deeper, play quarters. I know he has his tight end here, but that linebacker's doing a great job of getting his hand on him and carrying him deep. So he had no business jumping this route right away. So let's run it. Boom. And right where you see where this guy made his choice, this ball is already thrown to the skinny post. That's a tight window right there, guys. That's an impressive throw by Lobato for the touchdown. That's a great job by him. You're going to see right here in the end zone, from the end zone cam, what he can do from the pocket. And that's the most important thing. Can he read coverage? A great illustration of where these two safeties are aligned and what he sees. The middle of the field is open, but they're playing quarters coverage. These two guys are going to drop in their zones. Going to run it. Boom. Plant foot down. Stop. Now you see where his eyes help him out, because one, he's eyeing this post by the tight end, which then pulls the safety over, gets him out of his coverage. And once he sees that, he now has that window that we talked about for the touchdown. So that's a great job by Lobato. And the next clip we have here is versus Weber State. We're going to pause it right here. You see pre-snap cover two look. It looks like cover two man. These guys are up on the receivers showing press coverage. It could be cover two man. It could just be a straight cover two. You see the two safeties deep, but under center, off of play action, turning your back to the defense, having to reset your eyes, it's a big thing for a quarterback. That's what you call pro-style offense. Northern Colorado definitely ran a pro-style offense. That's one thing that doesn't get talked about a lot. When you have to turn your back to the defense and then have to reset your eyes, things change, things move on the fly, and Lobato does a great job in diagnosing coverage. So, see right here, man in motion. So that tells you right here, it's either cover two man, but you see the safety creeping down, so it may be cover zero. You may have a situation where there's no deep safety back deep, or at least it's cover one, because he's still back in his zone. We don't know what this guy is going to do just yet. So we're rolling it. Looks like man coverage off of play action. Turn your back to the defense. So pre-snap, he saw cover two. He also saw cover one with this guy. Now he resets. Boom. Now he sees his slot receiver is being taken by the safety. He now knows he has a wider range of options. He can go across the field with this slot guy. He has one-on-one on the outside. He can make a beautiful throw down the sideline. He also has the crosser coming back across the field. Now, where he takes advantage of the defense is at the corner and this linebacker, they have some type of combo coverage, some type of communication breakdown in this defense allowed this guy to be wide open. So you see right here, as this guy's coming open, patience, taking the road less travel. He could have had the deep corner here, the deep post here. Why take a chance when you can take the safe route which is the wide open receiver running against air, running free in the zone. And he makes a perfect throw. The receiver doesn't have to break stride, and it ends up being a touchdown anyway. So it's about taking the road less traveled. And you like what Lobato did there, showing patience, not getting greedy, trying to go for the home run right away. And it still worked out to his benefit. In the end, they were still able to get a touchdown and a big play versus Weber State on the road. You see right here again, full illustration, turning your back to the defense. Now you are blind as a quarterback. You don't know what you're seeing when you turn back around. So that's why you have to have patience, make a decision, get the ball out of your hand quickly. Perfect arc throw to the receiver crossing the field. Again, results in a touchdown and a big play for Northern Colorado. And finally, versus Idaho State, we're going to see here another example of Lobato doing a great job pre-snap with his reads and post-snap with his reads. And the one thing you see right here is your classic cover two defense. It could be regular cover two. It could be cover two man. 3-4 defense, 1-2-3-4 linebackers, 4 defensive backs, cover two. So pre-snap, he already knows where he can go with the football. Void in the cover two is down the sideline in between the corner and the safety. He can flood the zone with this tight end coming in motion with the receiver and the back going to the same side. He can flood the top of the screen, the strong side, with the tight end, H-back, receiver, and also tailback. So he has options on this play based off what he sees pre-snap. So let's see what happens post-snap and what he does with the football. So at the snap of the ball, you see right here, safety is now coming down. One guy deep. So that tells you right away, this is cover one. There's no cover two look. So on the fly, he's not even at the top of his drop. He has to make a decision of where he's going with the football. He has a crosser coming across the field, but he has a linebacker in chase with a linebacker ready to pick him up on this side. So they're going to pass him off to this linebacker as he crosses his face. He sees his H-back is going to be covered by that safety that he originally saw back in cover two. He now knows he has to beat one safety. He can either go up top or he can go on the bottom of the field. So boom, at the top of his drop, decision is made. That's what I like about Lobato. At the top of the drop, the ball has to be thrown. That eliminates angles, that eliminates instincts by defense. You have to be quick with your decisions and you have to be accurate with the football. He knows at the top of his drop, he's going down the sideline, puts this safety. Well, this safety's had a bad game against Northern Colorado, the safety for Idaho State, going down the sideline and makes a beautiful throw to the receiver over the shoulder, right where it needs to be, so the defender, who was in great position, couldn't make a catch. You're going to see from the end zone cam, pre-snap cover two look like we said before. It gives you those options of where you can go with the football. They slide their line this way, so he thinks now they're going to overload this side, so he's going to throw into the blitz. Really, they're not blitzing, but that's what the pre-snap looks like. So he now knows he has to get rid of this football, throws it down the sideline, beautiful throw to the receiver. So I'm gonna show you one more play versus Sacramento State here, what he does on the move. Good mobility for a guy that's 6'5", 230 pounds, getting outside, the first read isn't there. He knows he's gonna take a shot deep down the field, he's waiting for the receiver to get open, buy some time, finds him late, makes a beautiful throw, Joe Flacco-esque. Hits the receiver in stride. You like that about his game. So again, when you see a guy like Lobato and you look at where he can transition to the National Football League level, he definitely has pro-style game. And when you look at what he does well, you look at a guy that definitely can make all of the throws across the field. And this was just a small snapshot of what he can do. He has short throws. He has throws off of play action. He has deep throws. I just took a little bit of his game and just analyzed just a little bit. But I definitely think Lobato has what it takes to play in the National Football League.